In any plant piping, both butt weld end type and socket weld end type pipe fittings are used, like elbow, T, reducers, etc. Generally, socket weld end fittings are used up to 2 inch size, and butt weld end fittings are used for all sizes starting from half inch size. Now, commonly used socket weld fittings, material and dimensions. For carbon steel socket weld end fittings, commonly used material is ASTM A105 and dimensions as per ASME B16.11, and class rating can be 3000 pound, 6000 pound, 9000 pound, like that. For stainless steel socket weld fittings, commonly used material is ASTM A182 F304, F304L, like that. And alloy steel socket weld fittings, materials are ASTM A182 F11, like that. For butt weld end fittings, commonly used carbon steel fittings are as per ASTM A234 grade WPV, dimensions as per ASME B16.9. For stainless steel butt weld end fittings, material as per ASTM A403 grade WP304 304L, like that. For alloy steel butt weld end fittings, material as per ASTM A234 grade WP1, WP9, WP11, like that. Now we will see why butt weld end fittings are better compared to socket weld end fittings. Number one is, radiography is possible for butt weld end fittings but not possible for socket weld end fittings. Number two is, load transmission for butt weld end fittings is collinear along the pipe axis, but it is not collinear along the pipe axis for socket weld end fittings. Number three is, for socket weld fittings, possibility of mismatch in ID is there. That means there may be flow disturbances due to mismatch of ID. And number four is, for socket weld fittings, a cavity is created between socket inside and pipe outside, resulting corrosion. Now I have drawn two T pieces. One is socket weld end type left side and other is butt weld end type right side. T's are in gray color, pipeline in red color, and welding is in blue color. In case of socket weld end T, radiographic examination of fillet weld joint is not possible because pipeline is there in the background. So if we make radiography, then any flaw or crack in the weld joint cannot be seen. But in case of butt joint, entire weld joint can be radiographed because only welding is there, nothing is there in the background. So in any critical application where 100% radiographic requirement is there, then we should go for only butt weld end type fittings, not for socket weld end type fittings. Then second point is, load transmission. In case of any pipeline, there is thermal expansion or contraction and load is transmitted along the pipeline. In case of butt weld end fittings, the load is transmitted along the axis of the pipe and fittings, and there is no change in load transmission axis, and load is transmitted smoothly through the butt weld end fittings through the butt welding. But in case of socket weld end fittings, due to socket weld joint, load transmission axis changes, which creates a moment in fillet weld, and due to that moment, fillet weld joint may crack. Then third point is, for butt weld end fittings, fitting thickness is normally same as pipe thickness and there is no mismatch in ID. If some minor ID mismatch is there, then pipe or fittings can be grinded so that ID of both pipe and fittings will be matched. But in case of socket weld end fittings, depth of socket may not exactly match with pipe thickness or pipe ID. That's why we should specify socket weld fittings as 3000 pound and schedule 40 or 3000 pound and schedule 80, like that, so that depth of socket will match exactly with connected pipe thickness. Otherwise, there will be mismatch of pipe thickness and socket depth, and due to that mismatch, there will be sudden contraction or sudden expansion of the flow path. Then fourth point is, in case of socket weld end fittings, due to tolerance, there may be any annular cavity. That means there may be gap between pipe OD and socket ID. In this cavity, debris will be accumulated and finally corrosion will start from this area. Due to these 4-5 disadvantages, butt weld end fittings are always better than socket weld end fittings. But still, socket weld fittings are used in non-critical low pressure service where 100% radiographic requirement is not there, because fillet welding is cheaper and can be done quickly compared to butt welding. So we can conclude that socket weld end fittings should be used only for low pressure, non-critical, ambient temperature service where radiographic requirement is not there, but for all high pressure and high temperature critical service, only butt weld end fittings should be used. Same philosophy is applicable for socket weld flange and weld neck flange also, that means SWRF flange and WNRF flange.